you a sneak peek of our commercial aquaponics system today. So the system actually consists of two parts. We have our nursery part, which you can see over here, and then we have our grow out section that's over here. We sort all of our fish out in the nursery system, and when they get big enough, we move them into the grow out system. What that does, it allows for continuous production of fish. The nursery system actually consists of three different tanks. The fish start off in the fry tank, which is a small square tank here. So we'll get them at about a half a gram a piece, throw them in here, and they'll be there for about 6 weeks. At the end of those 6 weeks, we take those fish out and bring them to our fingerling tanks. They'll stay here for about 12 weeks. Doing that lets us bring in fish every 6 weeks, so we can continually bring fish in, and also later on harvest fish constantly. The fry tank here is about 55 gallons, and each fingerling tank is 250 gallons. Each fish can hold between 400 and 500 fish. Behind me is our bubble wash feed filter that comes with each of these systems. What this is going to do is going to remove all those solid waste that your fish produce, so you have clean water going out to your grow beds. So here's our grow out system, consisting of four 1,200 gallon tanks, each of which can hold between 400 and 500 fish, and each tank utilizes an internal standpipe design, which keeps the water level constant so it can't drain out, and it also separates each tank from each other. And from here, the water will drain to a drum filter that removes all the solid waste. The water is going to flow from your fish tanks into this micro-screen drum filter. This drum filter has a 60-micron mesh, so it's going to remove just about all the solids, even the tiny, tiny little particles. Now, what that's going to do is it's going to really make your water nice and clear and ready for biofiltration. The water flows from the drum filter to the biofilter. Now, the biofilter is packed with this media that has high surface area for bacteria to grow on to take the ammonia produced by the fish, convert it to nitrites, and then nitrates. That way, the water is safe for the fish, and it's nutrient-rich for the plants. After the solids have been removed from the water, and the ammonia successfully converted to nitrites and then nitrates, it can freely flow out to the grow beds. But first, it's got to stop this sump, which is a really, really great place for you to add things like acids or bases or do your water tests, things like that. Then it can flow right out to the raft as nutrient-rich water for your plants. So the grow-out system we just saw is designed to supply water to two 8-foot by 48-foot deep water culture rafts, which are in the greenhouse next door. And they're next to the 4-foot by 48-foot long media bed that the nursery system is designed to supply. Now, we just got fish here, so we're not quite ready for plants, but check back for our next video, and we'll show you how to grow there. Again, I'm Jeremy, and this was another episode of Steps and Scales. Try aquaponics. It's like fishing in a bucket.